Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel, Nicola's Food, my food islandware. And here's our ingredient for today. There's a big duck there. The duck is being clean and clean on fire, so that's why it's a little bit brown on there. We've got a big taro there to go with the duck, coconut cream. We've got a lamb here, lamb flaps. I'm gonna smoke that. Smoke it slowly in the smoker with some beans and choco and spinach, Indian spinach to go with it. And the curry I'm using is this one. It'll be beautiful, beautiful curry. It's got everything in it. All the So that's our Sunday lunch. Okay, I'm gonna make a curry. I'm gonna cut off the duck and do our curry. And our taro and our lamb. Okay, let's start cooking. Slow, nice and crunchy. Okay, I'm gonna just cut it off here. Sunday lunch. Nice little Maryland. Oh, yeah, Maryland. I hope you all well and having a really good weekend. Whatever you're doing on the weekend. Yeah, we've got two little Maryland. Okay, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut this up in small pieces. You really need a sharp knife. Ooh, that's loud. Come on, ducky.
Don't fight me.
She never wants to eat it. You just cut it all very small. Get rid of those bit of fat there. You can use it to fry the legs. I guess I'm gonna cut this up. It's too loud, too noisy to put it on a camera, and I'll be back. Hi guys, I already cut our duck. Cut it with bones. Now look at the size of that taro. I'm gonna peel one taro. Yeah, I'm gonna peel all my ingredients and get it all ready, and then I just cook and put everything in. Gotta be careful with that taro when you cut it with bones and eat it with bones. It's really careful with bones because bones are really hot. Okay, so easy to peel the taro when it's big and in a good shape. Look, guys, this is a Sunday morning here. I don't know if he's going to church or... Okay, I'm sitting at home making lunch. Here you go, guys. Size of our taro. Beautiful. Okay. Now I'm gonna peel our choco, cut our peas, our spinach. I'm gonna marinate our lamb. Big blade here. I'm gonna put our lamb on it. I'm gonna slice the top of the lamb. So put it in a smoker. Just give a little slice on the skin. So our herbs and our stuff going through. And the sun finally come out today. Can you see it shiny out there? Oh, what I'm going to do with, I'm going to add some dry garlic. Some marinade while the smoke I left. Just dip it on it. Okay, some of the finest herbs and spicy. Dry one. One in there. I've got some red paprika. Sweet paprika. Not spicy, no spicy on this lamb. Okay, some salt, add heaps of salt. I'm gonna get the oil, add a, put the oil on there, heaps. Some ginger with the skin, just grind it all over it. It's gonna be beautiful smoky lamb. It's gonna be full of flavor. The last time I smoked the lamb, it was different flavor, but this one, different flavor too. Gonna smoke it on the low for 2 hours. There you go. I need to get that teaser out of there. Okay, more salt. And you can use your hands. Yeah. Just cover the whole lamb. So it's like buttering it with a... Yeah, that lamb's gonna be delicious with all that ginger, the paprika, senorita, chile chila, and more salt just between the lamb. Some, you know, smokers work good with this salt, bit more oil. I'm gonna let it sit in here until it goes further. Let's smoke. It's our lamb, guys. See how easy to see what that is? Yeah, I'll put it aside. Okay, it's nearly time to make our curry. I'm gonna cut up the taro now and cook it. And I'll cook those drumsticks, the duck drum. Okay, guys, I've got a pot here. I'm gonna ready for our curry. I've got our curry here, and I'm gonna add a couple of spoons in my bowl. Start with. Come on. That's about. Oh my gosh, going all over the place. Damn it. Okay, I'll put some oil in there. Fry off our curry. I've got onion already sliced here. What I'm going to do, I'm going to add a bit of water into our curry to form into a paste. That way, if you make your curry become a paste so it doesn't burn when it comes in a heat oil as a powder. Okay. It's going into a paste. It's a little bit of water. That way when it hits the oil, it doesn't burn very fast. Okay. That curry's going in there. See what I'm talking about. All the smokes come from the water that we put in there. Frying off our curry first. Hopefully our lamb doesn't go off. Smoke alarm. A lot of aroma on that curry.
Okay, I'm adding the onions. That's beautiful, that huh? I asked the lady over there which curry is really good and nice because they like curry, the Indians. And I say take this one. Hope you can see it cooking. Pan is covered. That goes. Start adding our duck. See our duck's been cut up. It's cut up with bone, so really careful. Because the bone of the duck is very sharp and hard. So if you feed your family with it, there's a lot of flavor, but just be careful. Be careful with the bones. A lot of ducks. Stir it on in. So the duck's covered in curry. Up. Here I'm going to add some water. I'm going to add a glass of water in there. Many water in there to cook the duck a little bit and through that curry. And that way we'll bring out the natural fat of the duck. Okay. I'm going to put the lid on it. About that curry. But you can add powder now if you want, the curry powder. I think I'm going to add some now. Pour the water in there. It depends how strong your curry and how much you put in. When I've got the water in there, it's good to add the powder now. Let it go through the whole top. And once it water's nearly gone, you can turn it right down and cook it on low. Okay. Put more onion in there, put a lean on it. And I'm gonna get some of our ginger. What's my garlic? Some garlic. Nice and flavorful. I don't have to add too much in that curry because the curry itself is already got a lot of stuff, a lot of flavor. Go over there, it's very good price, very cheap. And you can one stop shop. Once you find everything there. You find breadfruit, lamb, duck, meat, everything. Just stir the bottom so it doesn't burn. Okay, there's our garlic. Probably my ginger. With the ginger, I'm gonna stir it off with a knife. Chanel. Everything will be cooked together. I already cut up our choco. I just peel the skin off and then cut it up. I keep the middle bit, the heart of the seeds of the choco. It's got a nice extra nutty flavor in there. This is a white tincture. The one I use for the lamb is a yellow tincture. Guys, if you want to go to St. Mary's and find some taro, some breadfruit, you've got frozen breadfruit, the ulus, they've got everything. It's a nice little shop to go to. Okay, I'm going to let that water simmer it down until it comes back to fry. By the time the water's gone, the oil of the duck's coming out. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. It's starting to be gone. Add a bit of salt. Okay. Give it a stir. Because the duck's took a while to cook, so it'll be perfect. By the time that water's gone, it's going to be cooked and nice and soft. Okay. Here's our taro. Such a big taro. The taros are cheap over there too, in St. Mary's. You don't need a machine yourself. Okay, I just cut it in the pieces. Okay guys, I'm going to put our taro in the hot water and cook it until the duck is slowly cooked. I turn it down halfway. I'm going to add a little bit of turmeric. Slowly, just maybe 1 tablespoon or 1/2 tablespoon. And stir that in. Just giving our curry its color. Okay, it's cooking really nicely. Keep stirring now and then, every 5 minutes. Okay, it's thickening up anyway, and it's getting all the water out. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. Hey guys, our curry now is, see the natural oil of the duck is coming out. That's beautiful. I'm not gonna let it fry now. I'm just gonna add the choco now. Looking good, our duck. Add a choco and lemon and keep cooking it on low. Okay. Keep stirring it at the bottom. Just make sure it doesn't burn. I keep the seeds in a, cut it in with a choco. It's really nice and it's good for you. Yeah, let's give it a little stir. It's going to be hard to stir because it's heavy, too dark, and I just need to get that choco on the bottom. Okay, put the lid back on it and keep cooking on low. Soon I'll add our beans and our the spinach. It's Indian spinach, Asian spinach. Okay, and I'm gonna go in there now. We've got a smoker lighter, and I put our lamb on. Okay, let me pick in a minute. Our taro is ready for coconut cream in it. Everything is cooking at the same time. So I was fucked up with the camera. This is my salmon taro. It's gonna grow. Look at the mints there, peppermints. New lemons coming in. I'm gonna turn the stove on. Okay. I'm just gonna brown this off, the skin off, and straight in the oven. What I'm gonna need in there, put it on a table. Take a bit of dark fat in there, throw it in there. Give it a nice flavor. just put a bit of salt on the skin. And the inside, I'm cooking this for my neighbors. My older neighbors that just came out from the hospital. And yeah, bit of oil in there. And heat it up. And yeah, salt. Since the oil heating up, we just brown our dark leg. And put a fry pan straight in the oven. Okay. Wanted that skin to go down. I'm gonna add in there a couple of cloves of garlic. Wash it up and put it aside. The flavor runs through the duck. With the skin, get a pincher, slice it up, the skin on. We're just getting the flavor into the duck. And the whole fry pan will go in the oven with my salt. Okay, just throw it up. A bit of fat there. Dark fat. And our guy here is still going. I cannot believe it. I thought it would be cooking quicker, but I hope I didn't get it all dark. But it's getting there. It's just on low. Our choco is cooking. Maybe next time I'll just get duck breasts. Maybe because of the bone in there, it's taking a while. Yeah. Moving around those ginger and those garlic, get a flavor into the duck. Brown part of the skin. Okay, put it in there and the oil on that garlic and ginger is running into the bowl. So what I'm going to do with this, just going to seal it off, brown it up, and straight in the oven. We'll be back in a minute. Hey guys, doing enough on the skin. So just turn it over. Just brown up the bottom now and then straight in the oven. See all that ginger and garlic there? Down here. Okay, I'll just brown the bottom up and then take it to the oven. Lamb is here, guys. It's cooking on low, nearly ready. Hey guys, welcome back. Okay, at the boat here, I already take the most of the dark fat out. Skip it out from the top, and look, our choco now is nearly all melted into the duck. I find it's really rough duck. But it's been cooking now for 2.5 hours and it's still a bit rough, but okay, I'm gonna add a little bit of coconut cream. Add another bit. It smells so good. Our lamb is nearly done, it's still smoky outside. What we're going to do, we're going to add our beans. Let's break it in half, throw it in there. Didn't add no flour, no nothing in there. I'm just picking up by the sauce of the dark and what do you call? The choco is all half melt, so it's picking our curry up. And just stir that in. It's much better show with a cameraman, so the camera can come really close to the food. But I guess not. Okay, I've got spinach here. I never used this spinach before. It's the first time I used this spinach. But it's Asian Indian spinach. So let's give it a try, but I'm gonna cut it small where the stems are. Cut it small. Put it in there. Finger cross will come out nice. Inside, just cut it roughly big. There you go. I'm sure there's going to be more juice come out of that, those spinach and the leaves. Green beans. Then we're nearly done here, guys. Just give it 5 minutes now to cook our spinach and our peas, and yeah. Then it brings to the boil, and then turn it off. Lean on it. That's it. Give it 5 minutes to cook our vegetable, and then done. Hi guys, I'm all done now. I've got my neighbor's, only neighbor's food here already served. That's Maryland duck, the smoky lamb, some taro with coconut cream, and our duck curry. Yummy. I'm ready to eat and serve the neighbor first. They've been just out of the hospital not long ago, so I hope they enjoy this food. And yeah, we've got our taro in there and our duck curry in there. And yeah, I'm gonna get everything to get a neighbor's food, take a neighbor's food, or I can taste this food. Okay, that's it. Hey guys, well, thank you for watching and thank you for subscribing. Yeah, let's test this food. I'm gonna get a piece of taro. That taro looks so good. Look, over that cream, I put garlic, drops of garlic in there when I boil the taro. I'm gonna have that piece of lamb. It's all smoking, look, it's dripping. Drip. Okay. And I'll get myself a little bit of curry. I don't want a bone and meat. Just want to taste a little bit. There you go. Yeah, all done, guys. It's in simple, just the duck was taking ages to cook. Hope it's softing now. Still a bit. Jury, maybe it's all done. Hey guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to go to that shop if you want looking for island food and Indian food, Asian food. It's all there. It's just, what's the name again? It's a Pacific Green Grocery. Yeah, okay. Happy Sunday, everybody. Hope you enjoy your day, your weekend. And yeah. So put that curry on my tongue. A little bit of a tuck. It's cooked really well. You see? So I was saying before about the bones. Be careful about the bones. A beautiful curry. Yum, it's not hard at all. This is our lamb, our smoky lamb. Oh, yummy. Tell him to come and take the neighbor's food. Look at me. I'm not really eating, I'm just tasting it. It's delicious. The beans just crunchy, yeah. Because I turn it off very quick when after I put a spinach in it. Yummy, guys. But I think it's better to buy the duck breast. That way you don't have the bones. I didn't have to put the bones in there, but I wanted the flavor of the bones. So it's taking ages to go. But worth every moment. Another time. Okay. You better come and get the neighbor's food. Thank you guys for watching, and thank you for your subscribe, and thank you for your time. I hope you're all well and safe, and love to your family, you and your family, and much love. And I'll see you in the next video. God bless you.